Joel's fingers drummed impatiently on the steering wheel as he navigated the familiar route to his mother's favorite nightclub. The neon lights of the city blurred into a kaleidoscope of colors outside the car window, but Joel's mind was elsewhere. He couldn't believe he was once again playing chauffeur for his mother's late-night escapades. It had been weeks since Carly, his mom, had started using that damn swap app, transforming herself into a 21-year-old party girl. And with each passing night, Joel's patience wore thinner. The car came to a halt in front of the club, and Joel glanced at the clock on the dashboard. 11:45 p.m. Another late night. He sighed deeply, running a hand through his tousled hair. "Mom, we need to talk," he said, his voice tinged with frustration. Carly, now a vivacious young woman with shimmering blonde hair and a figure that turned heads, leaned over the console, her eyes sparkling with mischief. "Oh, come on, Joel. Don't be such a stick in the mud. Live a little." She planted a kiss on his cheek, leaving a faint trace of her lipstick. Joel swatted her away, his irritation mounting. "This has gone too far. You're supposed to be working, not gallivanting around town like some college kid. What happened to your job? To our bills?" Carly pouted, her lower lip jutting out in a way that would have melted hearts if Joel hadn't been so exasperated. "Relax, Joel. I know what I'm doing. Besides, you've got plenty of time to worry about all that. You're just sitting around playing video games all day." "That's not fair," Joel retorted, his voice rising. "I'm trying to find a job, but it's not easy out there." "Well, maybe if you spent less time gaming and more time networking, you'd have better luck," Carly shot back, her tone sharp. The argument hung in the air, thick with tension. Joel clenched his fists, feeling the weight of their unresolved issues pressing down on him. Finally, he spoke, his voice low and determined. "Mom, I'm serious. This needs to stop. You need to start acting your age." Carly's expression softened, but there was a glint of something else in her eyes, something calculating. "Fine," she said slowly, her voice dripping with false sweetness. "If that's how you feel, then maybe it's time you learned what it's like to walk in my shoes." Before Joel could react, Carly pulled out her phone and opened the swap app. Her fingers danced across the screen with a practiced ease, and within seconds, a soft glow enveloped them both. The air seemed to hum with energy, a faint crackling that made the hair on Joel's arms stand on end. He blinked in confusion, but before he could process what was happening, a strange, foreign sensation began to wash over him, as if his very essence was being unraveled and rearranged, like someone was pulling at the strings of his soul. At first, it was subtle, a mere tingling at the center of his chest, but it quickly spread, radiating outward in rippling waves, to the furthest reaches of his body. The tingling turned into a prickling warmth, like the sensation of a limb falling asleep, but this time it was his entire being. Joel gasped, eyes widening, as he felt the first tangible changes begin to occur. His skin was the first to shift. He could feel it almost bubbling beneath the surface, the texture altering. It felt like his skin was loosening, then tightening again, becoming smoother, softer, as though years of wear and tear were being erased in an instant. He glanced down at his hands in disbelief, watching in real time as they shrank, the knuckles smoothing, the veins disappearing beneath the surface. His fingers lengthened, becoming more slender and graceful, the pads of his fingertips softening to a delicate, almost ethereal touch. His nails grew too, extending out into perfect, rounded ovals, glossy and immaculate, as if they had just been manicured. A wave of dizziness hit him as his bones began to shift beneath his skin. He could feel his frame reshaping itself, as if invisible hands were molding him like clay. His shoulders, once broad and angular, pulled inward with an almost painful snap, narrowing to a more delicate width. His chest tightened, a strange pressure building beneath his skin, and he could feel his ribcage compressing, reshaping itself into a smaller, more feminine form. It was both unsettling and oddly exhilarating. His body was being transformed, but he felt trapped inside, powerless to stop it. His breath hitched as the pressure in his chest grew more acute. He looked down in horror as his pectoral muscles softened and swelled, pushing outward into two soft mounds. His shirt tightened around his chest as small, yet firm breasts formed, their weight foreign and disorienting. His heart raced, and the fabric of his shirt strained against his newly developed curves. Lower down, the changes continued, and Joel could feel his waist cinching inward. His stomach flattened, muscles tightening in a way that felt unnatural, as if an invisible corset was being drawn tighter and tighter. His hips, once narrow and boyish, began to widen, the bones creaking and groaning as they expanded into a soft, rounded curve. His thighs thickened, filling out with a new layer of softness, and his legs took on a shapely, feminine contour. The sensation of his body reshaping itself was dizzying, bewildering, and Joel found himself struggling to maintain his balance as his center of gravity shifted. His pants, once comfortably loose, felt increasingly tight, the fabric straining against his widening hips and newly rounded rear. He could feel his backside swelling, his flesh growing softer, fuller, and the sensation of his body filling out in places where it had once been flat and angular was both alien and deeply unsettling. His legs, too, began to change, the muscles slimming and elongating, becoming more toned but also more graceful. Even his feet shrank, the bones within them narrowing as they became daintier, more delicate. Meanwhile, his hair began to grow. He could feel it almost like a physical pull at his scalp, the short strands lengthening rapidly, cascading down over his ears and around his neck. He reached up instinctively, fingers trembling, as his hair continued to grow, soft waves of chestnut brown spilling over his shoulders, brushing against his upper back. The weight of it was unfamiliar, the sensation of long hair tickling his neck and shoulders making him shiver. But it wasn't just his body. His face, too, was changing, and Joel could feel it happening, his features softening, shifting like clay being gently molded. His jawline, once sharp and masculine, became softer, more rounded, the angles melting away into a delicate curve. His cheekbones rose, becoming more pronounced, giving his face an elegant, feminine structure. His lips tingled as they plumped, becoming fuller, more luscious, and his nose slimmed, the bridge narrowing slightly to match the new femininity of his face. His eyes, once deep-set and square, shifted too, becoming larger, more almond-shaped, with longer lashes framing them, giving him a more doe-eyed, expressive look. Even his voice began to change, the deep timbre of his speech rising in pitch until it was softer, higher, almost melodious. He tried to speak, but the sound that came out was so unfamiliar, so foreign, that it sent a wave of panic through him. His clothes felt increasingly ill-fitting, the fabric clinging awkwardly to his new curves. His shirt strained at the chest, while his pants threatened to split around his widened hips, and his shoes felt loose on his now smaller feet. The world around him seemed to tilt and spin as his body continued to adjust to its new proportions, his balance and sense of spatial awareness thrown completely off. And then, as quickly as it had begun, the tingling sensation started to fade. Joel's vision blurred momentarily, and he staggered, disoriented, his heart pounding in his chest. When his vision cleared, he instinctively looked toward the rearview mirror, eyes widening in shock at the reflection staring back at him. It wasn't his face. It was her face, his mother's face. Her familiar features stared back at him in disbelief, the same chestnut hair, the same high cheekbones, the same full lips and almond-shaped eyes. "No, no, no, no," Joel whispered, his voice trembling, no longer his voice, but hers. His mother's voice. The unmistakable, soft, feminine tone sent a shiver down his spine. Panic surged through him, his heart hammering in his chest. "What did you do?" he demanded, turning to Carly, his voice cracking with fear and confusion. The realization hit him like a tidal wave. He was no longer Joel. He was her. Carly, now in Joel's body, smirked triumphantly. "Consider this a lesson in responsibility, dear. You wanted me to act my age? Well, now you can experience it firsthand. Take care of the house, work my job, and pay the bills. Maybe then you'll understand why I needed a break." Joel's mind raced as he tried to process the situation. His body felt different, heavier, and there was an unfamiliar tightness in his chest. He looked down at his hands, no, her hands, and saw the subtle signs of aging. Wrinkles, age spots, and a softness that hadn't been there before. "This isn't funny, Mom," Joel said, his voice wavering. "You can't just swap us like this." "Oh, but I can," Carly replied, her tone light but firm. "And I will. Now, get out of the car and go home. You've got a lot to learn." Joel hesitated, his heart pounding in his chest. The reality of the situation was sinking in, and with it came a wave of anxiety. He had no choice but to comply. As he stepped out of the car, he felt the cool night air brush against his skin, a stark reminder of the life he was now living. Carly, in Joel's body, watched him with a satisfied smile. "Good luck, son. I'll see you soon." Joel walked away, his steps heavy and uncertain. The world around him seemed both familiar and alien, a twisted reflection of the life he knew. As he approached the front door of their home, he couldn't shake the feeling of dread that gnawed at him. This was only the beginning, and he had no idea what challenges awaited him. Inside the house, everything was exactly as he remembered it, yet different. The furniture, the decorations, even the smell of the place, it was all the same, but filtered through the lens of his mother's perspective. He wandered into the kitchen, his stomach growling despite the unease that gripped him. Opening the fridge, he found it stocked with food, but nothing appealed to him. Instead, he grabbed a bottle of water and took a long, slow sip, trying to calm his nerves. As he stood there, lost in thought, his phone buzzed in his pocket. Pulling it out, he saw a message from Carly. "Don't forget, tomorrow's Monday. You have a meeting with HR at 9 a.m. Better get some sleep." Joel groaned, dropping the phone onto the counter. Sleep was the last thing on his mind. He felt trapped, confined in a body that wasn't his own, forced to navigate a life that was foreign to him. But there was no turning back now. He had to face the consequences of his actions, and that meant stepping into his mother's shoes, literally and figuratively. His gaze drifted to the hallway, where a full-length mirror stood. Hesitating for a moment, he walked over and stared at his reflection. The woman looking back at him was a stranger, yet somehow familiar. Her eyes, once bright and youthful, now held a depth of experience and weariness. Her lips, usually curved in a warm smile, were pressed into a thin line of determination. Joel reached up, touching his face, feeling the texture of her skin under his fingertips. It was surreal, almost dreamlike, but undeniably real. He let out a shaky breath, his mind racing with questions and fears. How was he going to manage this new life? How would he explain this to anyone? And most importantly, how was he going to reverse this bizarre transformation? As he stood there, lost in thought, the sound of footsteps echoed through the house. Turning around, he saw Carly, now in his body, walking towards him, a mischievous grin on her face. "Enjoying the view?" she teased, her voice light and playful. Joel glared at her, his frustration boiling over. "This isn't a joke, Mom. What am I supposed to do now?" Carly's grin widened, and she sauntered closer, her movements fluid and confident. "First things first, you need to get ready for bed. Tomorrow's a big day, and you don't want to be tired for your first day at work, do you?" Joel's heart skipped a beat as he realized the implications of her words. Work? He had never held a job in his life, let alone one that required him to dress professionally and interact with colleagues. The thought alone was enough to make him break out in a cold sweat. "I can't do this," he muttered, his voice barely audible. Carly placed a reassuring hand on his shoulder, her touch surprisingly gentle. "Yes, you can. And you will. Remember, this is all part of growing up. Now, go upstairs and get changed. I'll help you pick out something to wear." Joel hesitated, his mind a whirlwind of emotions. But deep down, he knew there was no other choice. With a heavy sigh, he nodded and made his way upstairs, his steps slow and uncertain. In the bedroom, he rummaged through his mother's closet, feeling overwhelmed by the array of clothes and accessories. He had never paid much attention to fashion, but now he was faced with the daunting task of dressing like a professional woman. His hands trembled as he selected a blouse and skirt, unsure if they would fit or if they were appropriate for the office. As he began to undress, he couldn't help but notice the differences between his old body and his new one. The curves, the softness, the slight sagging of skin, it was all so foreign, yet undeniably real. He paused, his fingers brushing against the fabric of his underwear, feeling a strange mix of embarrassment and curiosity. "Need any help?" Carly's voice broke through his thoughts, making him jump. He turned to see her standing in the doorway, her arms crossed over her chest. "I think I can manage," he said, his voice strained. Carly raised an eyebrow, her expression unreadable. Suit yourself. But remember, you're not just dressing for comfort. You're dressing to impress. Make sure everything fits properly. Joel nodded, though he still felt lost. As he slipped into the blouse and skirt, he struggled with the buttons and zippers, his fingers fumbling with the unfamiliar garments. When he finally emerged from the bathroom, he felt a mixture of relief and trepidation. Carly inspected him critically, her eyes narrowing as she assessed his appearance. Not bad, she said after a moment. But you could use a bit more makeup. Trust me, it makes a difference. Joel's eyes widened in horror. Makeup? I can't wear makeup. Carly chuckled, shaking her head. Of course you can. And you will. Come on, sit down. I'll show you how. Reluctantly, Joel obeyed, taking a seat at the vanity table. As Carly applied foundation, eyeliner, and lipstick, he felt a strange sense of detachment, as if he were watching someone else's life unfold. The brush strokes and touches of color transformed his face, adding a layer of sophistication and allure that he had never experienced before. When she finished, Carly stepped back, admiring her handiwork. There. Perfect. Now you look the part. Joel stared at his reflection, hardly recognizing the woman staring back at him. The makeup accentuated her features, giving her an air of confidence and elegance that he had never possessed. He swallowed hard, feeling a lump form in his throat. Time to get ready for bed, go wash all that off and get to bed, you have a big day tomorrow. Carly said, her tone softer now. Joel nodded, though he didn't feel ready for anything. As he climbed into bed, he couldn't shake the feeling of unease that clung to him like a shadow. Tomorrow would bring new challenges, new responsibilities, and he had no idea how he would cope. As he lay there, staring at the ceiling, he heard Carly's voice drift through the darkness. Good night, Joel. Sweet dreams. Joel closed his eyes, hoping that sleep would offer some respite from the chaos of his new life. But as he drifted off, one thought lingered in his mind: how was he going to survive this? Joel's alarm blared at 7 a.m., jolting him awake. He groaned, rolling over to silence the incessant beeping. The room was dimly lit, casting long shadows across the walls. He rubbed his eyes, trying to shake off the remnants of sleep. Today was the first day of his new life, and he felt anything but prepared. He stumbled out of bed, his legs feeling unsteady in his mother's body. The unfamiliar weight of her curves pressed against the fabric of his nightgown, making him feel self-conscious. He shuffled to the bathroom, his mind racing with anxiety. What if someone at work noticed something off? What if he couldn't handle the responsibilities? After a quick shower, he stood in front of the mirror, applying the makeup Carly had shown him the night before. The process felt awkward and unnatural, but he followed her instructions carefully. Foundation, eyeliner, mascara, lipstick, each step added a layer of complexity to his appearance. When he finished, he stared at his reflection, hardly recognizing the woman staring back at him. He dressed in the blouse and skirt Carly had chosen for him, feeling the fabric cling to his new curves. The outfit was professional, yet it made him feel exposed. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. There was no turning back now. As he walked downstairs, he found Carly sitting at the kitchen table, sipping coffee. She looked up, her eyes assessing him critically. Looking good, she said, a hint of amusement in her voice. Ready for your big day? Joel nodded, though he didn't feel ready at all. He grabbed a piece of toast and quickly ate it, his stomach churning with anxiety. I guess I should get going, he said, his voice trembling slightly. Carly stood up and walked over to him, placing a reassuring hand on his shoulder. You'll do fine. Just remember, you're not alone. If you need help, just ask. Joel nodded again, forcing a smile. He grabbed his purse and headed out the door, feeling the weight of his mother's life pressing down on him. The drive to work was a blur. Joel tried to focus on the road, but his mind kept drifting to the challenges ahead. When he finally arrived at the office building, his heart pounded in his chest. He parked the car and took a deep breath, steeling himself for what lay ahead. The lobby was bustling with activity. People in suits and dresses moved briskly, their conversations filling the air. Joel felt a wave of anxiety wash over him as he approached the reception desk. "Good morning," he said, her voice sounding strange even to her own ears. The receptionist smiled warmly. "Good morning, Ms. Thompson. Your meeting with HR is in 10 minutes. Joel nodded, her mouth dry. "Thank you." She made her way to the elevator, her heels clicking against the marble floor. The ride up to the fifth floor seemed to take an eternity. When the doors finally opened, she stepped out into the hallway, her heart racing. The HR department was located at the end of the hall. Joel took a deep breath and walked towards the door, her steps slow and deliberate. She knocked softly and waited for a response. "Come in," a voice called from inside. Joel pushed open the door and stepped into the room. A middle-aged woman sat behind a large desk, her expression warm and welcoming. "Ms. Thompson, please have a seat," she said, gesturing to a chair. Joel sat down, her hands trembling slightly. The woman smiled kindly. "I'm glad you could make it today. We have a few things to go over before you start your new position." Joel nodded, her mind racing. She listened intently as the woman explained the company policies, benefits, and expectations. Each word felt like a weight pressing down on her, adding to her growing sense of dread. When the meeting finally ended, Joel felt a mixture of relief and apprehension. She thanked the woman and left the room, her steps heavy with uncertainty. As she walked through the office, she couldn't shake the feeling that everyone was watching her, judging her. Her first task was to meet with her team. She made her way to the marketing department, her heart pounding in her chest. The office was filled with cubicles, each one occupied by a worker focused on their tasks. Joel felt a wave of anxiety wash over her as she approached her supervisor's office. "Good morning, Ms. Thompson," a young man greeted her as she entered. "We're excited to have you join our team." Joel forced a smile, her mind racing. "Thank you. I'm looking forward to working with everyone." The man introduced her to the rest of the team, each member offering a polite greeting. Joel nodded and smiled, her mind struggling to keep up with the introductions. When the formalities were over, she was led to her cubicle, where a computer and various office supplies awaited her. She sat down, her hands trembling as she powered on the computer. The screen flickered to life, displaying a series of emails and documents. Joel took a deep breath, trying to calm her nerves. She had to focus, had to prove that she could handle this new life. As the day progressed, Joel found herself slowly settling into the routine. She answered emails, attended meetings, and collaborated with her colleagues. Each task was a challenge, but she managed to complete them with a combination of determination and sheer willpower. By lunchtime, she felt a sense of accomplishment. She had survived the morning, and while she still felt out of place, she was starting to adapt. She decided to take a break and head to the cafeteria, hoping some food would help clear her mind. The cafeteria was bustling with activity. People chatted and laughed, their voices filling the air. Joel picked up a tray and joined the line, her eyes scanning the options. She chose a salad and a bottle of water, her stomach growling despite the unease that gripped her. As she paid for her meal, she felt a tap on her shoulder. Turning around, she saw a familiar face, a coworker named Mark. He was tall, with dark hair and a friendly smile. "Hey, Carly," he said, his voice warm. "Mind if I join you?" Joel hesitated for a moment, then nodded. "Sure, Mark. That would be nice." They found a quiet corner and sat down, their trays placed between them. Mark chatted easily, asking about her morning and sharing stories from his own experiences. Joel found herself relaxing, enjoying the conversation. For the first time since the transformation, she felt a glimmer of normalcy. As they talked, Mark's gaze occasionally drifted to her lips, lingering for a moment before returning to her eyes. Joel felt a strange flutter in her chest, a mix of curiosity and nervousness. She had never experienced such attention before, and it made her feel both uneasy and intrigued. When lunch ended, they returned to their respective desks. Joel found herself thinking about Mark, his easygoing demeanor, and the way he had looked at her. It was a foreign sensation, one that she wasn't sure how to process. The afternoon passed in a blur of tasks and meetings. By the time the workday ended, Joel felt exhausted but satisfied. She had made it through her first day, and while there were still many challenges ahead, she felt a sense of accomplishment. As she packed up her belongings, she noticed Mark approaching her cubicle. "Hey, Carly," he said, his voice soft. "How was your first day?" Joel smiled, feeling a warmth spread through her chest. "It was challenging, but I think I did okay." Mark nodded, his eyes locking onto hers. "You did great. I was impressed." Joel felt a blush creep up her cheeks, her heart fluttering in her chest. "Thanks, Mark. That means a lot." He leaned in closer, his voice dropping to a whisper. "Listen, I know it's been a tough transition for you. If you ever need someone to talk to, or just want to grab a drink after work, I'm here for you." Joel's breath caught in her throat, her mind racing. This was the last thing she had expected, and yet, it stirred something deep within her. I might take you up on that offer," she said, her voice barely above a whisper. Mark smiled, his eyes twinkling with mischief. "Great. How about tomorrow evening? We can unwind and celebrate your first day." Joel nodded, her heart pounding in her chest. "That sounds perfect." As Mark walked away, Joel felt a mix of excitement and apprehension. She had accepted his invitation, and while it was innocent enough, she couldn't shake the feeling that something more was brewing beneath the surface. She gathered her things and headed out of the office, her mind swirling with thoughts of the future. As she drove home, she couldn't help but wonder what tomorrow would bring. Would she continue to navigate this new life with grace, or would she stumble under the weight of her responsibilities? When she arrived home, she found Carly waiting for her. "How was your day?" she asked, her tone curious. Joel sighed, collapsing onto the couch. "It was different. But I think I handled it okay." Carly smiled, her eyes gleaming with satisfaction. "I knew you would. And don't worry, it gets easier with time." Joel nodded, though she wasn't entirely convinced. As she prepared for bed, she couldn't shake the memory of Mark's invitation. Tomorrow would bring new challenges, and she had no idea what lay ahead. But as she drifted off to sleep, one thought lingered in her mind: perhaps this new life wouldn't be so bad after all. Joel's heart raced as he stood in front of the mirror, adjusting the collar of his blouse. The fabric felt strange against his skin, a constant reminder of the life he now inhabited. He took a deep breath, trying to calm the nervous flutter in his chest. Tonight was different. Tonight, he would meet Mark for drinks. He had spent the day at work, his mind constantly drifting back to their conversation. Mark's easygoing demeanor and the way he looked at him had left an indelible mark on Joel's thoughts. It was a foreign sensation, one that he wasn't sure how to process. But as the workday ended, he found himself looking forward to the evening ahead. Joel grabbed his purse and headed out the door, the cool evening air brushing against his skin. The bar where they were meeting was just a short drive away, but the journey felt like an eternity. Each mile closer brought with it a mix of excitement and apprehension. What if he said something wrong? What if he didn't live up to the expectations of the woman he was supposed to be? When he finally arrived at the bar, he spotted Mark sitting at a corner table, a drink already in hand. Joel's pulse quickened as he approached, the sound of laughter and clinking glasses filling the air around him. Mark looked up and smiled, his eyes lighting up with recognition. "Hey, Carly," he said, standing up to greet him. "You made it." Joel nodded, feeling a blush creep up his cheeks.
"Yeah,
I did. Traffic wasn't too bad." Mark gestured to the seat across from him. "Have a seat. Can I get you something to drink?" Joel sat down, his hands trembling slightly. "A glass of wine would be great, thanks." Mark signaled the bartender, who quickly brought over a glass of red wine. Joel took a sip, the liquid warm and soothing as it slid down his throat. He felt a sense of relief wash over him, the tension in his shoulders easing slightly. They chatted easily, the conversation flowing smoothly between them. Mark told stories of his past experiences, while Joel shared anecdotes from his first day at work. As the night wore on, Joel found himself relaxing, the initial anxiety giving way to a growing sense of comfort. Mark's gaze often lingered on him, his eyes filled with a warmth that made Joel's heart race. There was something about the way he looked at him that stirred something deep within. It was a feeling he hadn't experienced before, and it both intrigued and unnerved him. As the evening progressed, the atmosphere in the bar grew more intimate. The lights dimmed, casting a soft glow over the room, and the music shifted to a slower, more sensual beat. Joel felt a shiver run down his spine as Mark leaned in closer, his voice dropping to a whisper. "You know, Carly," he said, his breath warm against Joel's ear. "I've been thinking about you all day." Joel's heart skipped a beat, his breath catching in his throat. "Really?" he asked, his voice barely above a whisper. Mark nodded, his eyes locking onto Joel's.
"Yeah.
You're different from anyone I've met before. There's something about you that draws me in." Joel felt a flush of heat spread through his body, his mind racing with possibilities. He had never been in this position before, never had someone look at him with such intensity. It was both thrilling and terrifying. Mark reached out, his hand gently brushing against Joel's arm. The touch sent a jolt of electricity through him, making his skin tingle with anticipation. "Can I ask you something?" Mark said, his voice low and husky. Joel swallowed hard, his mouth dry. "Sure," he replied, his voice trembling slightly. Mark hesitated for a moment, his eyes searching Joel's face. "Do you want to get out of here? Maybe go somewhere more private?" Joel's breath caught in his throat, his mind racing with conflicting emotions. Part of him wanted to say yes, to explore this newfound attraction, but another part of him was terrified of what might happen next. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. I don't know," he stammered, his heart pounding in his chest. Mark's expression softened, his hand still resting on Joel's arm. "It's okay. Take your time. I just thought, maybe we could spend some more time together, get to know each other better." Joel felt a wave of relief wash over him, the tension in his shoulders easing slightly. He nodded, his mind slowly coming to a decision. "All right," he said, his voice steadier now. "Let's go somewhere else." Mark smiled, his eyes twinkling with mischief. "Great. Follow me." They left the bar, the cool night air brushing against their skin as they walked to Mark's car. Joel's heart raced as they drove through the city, the streets illuminated by the soft glow of streetlights. They eventually arrived at a quiet neighborhood, the houses dark and silent. Mark parked the car and led Joel to a small bungalow, the exterior painted a soft shade of blue. He unlocked the door and stepped inside, flipping on a light switch. The interior was cozy, with comfortable furniture and warm, inviting colors. "Make yourself at home," Mark said, gesturing to the living room. Joel nodded, feeling a mix of excitement and apprehension as he took a seat on the couch. Mark joined him, sitting close enough that their knees brushed together. The contact sent a shiver down Joel's spine, his heart pounding in his chest. Mark leaned in closer, his voice dropping to a whisper. "So, what do you want to do now?" Joel's mind raced, his thoughts a whirlwind of possibilities. He had never been in this situation before, never had someone so close to him, so intent on exploring whatever was brewing between them. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. I don't know," he admitted, his voice trembling slightly. Mark smiled, his eyes locking onto Joel's. "It's okay. We can take things slow. Just tell me what you want." Joel felt a flush of heat spread through his body, his mind racing with thoughts of what he might want. He had never been in this position before, never had someone so attentive, so willing to give him control. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. I think I want to kiss you," he said, his voice barely above a whisper. Mark's smile widened, his eyes gleaming with satisfaction. "All right," he said, his voice low and husky. "If that's what you want." He leaned in closer, his lips brushing against Joel's. The contact sent a jolt of electricity through him, making his skin tingle with anticipation. Joel closed his eyes, savoring the sensation, the warmth of Mark's lips against his own. The kiss deepened, Mark's tongue slipping into Joel's mouth, exploring every inch. Joel moaned softly, his body responding instinctively to the touch. He wrapped his arms around Mark's neck, pulling him closer, the heat between them intensifying with each passing moment. Mark's hands roamed over Joel's body, his fingers tracing the curves of his new form. The touch sent shivers down Joel's spine, his mind racing with thoughts of what might come next. He had never felt anything like this before, never experienced such intense physical pleasure. As the kiss continued, Mark's hands moved lower, slipping beneath the hem of Joel's blouse. The contact sent a jolt of electricity through him, making his skin tingle with anticipation. He gasped softly, his body arching into the touch, the heat between them intensifying with each passing moment. Mark's fingers danced over Joel's skin, his touch gentle yet firm. Joel moaned softly, his body responding instinctively to the sensation. He had never felt anything like this before, never experienced such intense physical pleasure. "You feel so good," Mark whispered, his voice low and husky. "So soft, so warm." Joel's breath caught in his throat, his mind racing with thoughts of what might come next. He had never been in this position before, never had someone so attentive, so willing to give him control. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. "Please," he whispered, his voice trembling slightly. "Touch me more." Mark's smile widened, his eyes gleaming with satisfaction. "Anything you want," he said, his voice low and husky. He leaned in closer, his lips brushing against Joel's neck. The contact sent a jolt of electricity through him, making his skin tingle with anticipation. Joel moaned softly, his body arching into the touch, the heat between them intensifying with each passing moment. Mark's hands roamed over Joel's body, his fingers tracing the curves of his new form. The touch sent shivers down Joel's spine, his mind racing with thoughts of what might come next. He had never felt anything like this before, never experienced such intense physical pleasure. As the kiss continued, Mark's hands moved lower, slipping beneath the waistband of Joel's skirt. The contact sent a jolt of electricity through him, making his skin tingle with anticipation. He gasped softly, his body arching into the touch, the heat between them intensifying with each passing moment. Mark's fingers danced over Joel's skin, his touch gentle yet firm. Joel moaned softly, his body responding instinctively to the sensation. He had never felt anything like this before, never experienced such intense physical pleasure. "You feel so good," Mark whispered, his voice low and husky. "So soft, so warm." Joel's breath caught in his throat, his mind racing with thoughts of what might come next. He had never been in this position before, never had someone so attentive, so willing to give him control. He took a deep breath, trying to steady his nerves. "Please," he whispered, his voice trembling slightly. "Touch me more." Mark's smile widened, his eyes gleaming with satisfaction. "Anything you want," he said, his voice low and husky.